We are going to start a new chapter, that is cell, the unit of life. First, we will start with who discovered cell, or what is the discovery of cell. So, the first basic information, this is a very basic information and important as well. So, the first one, cell was discovered by a scientist called Robert Hooke. Now, it's important to note that Robert Hooke, this scientist, discovered a cell in a dead tissue, in a dead cork tissue. So, in a dead cork tissue, Robert Hooke discovered the cell. And cork tissue is the tissue of oak tree, or in scientific terms, Quercus super. So, this is the discovery of the cell. Cell was discovered by a scientist called Robert Hooke. Now, Robert Hooke discovered in a dead cell. That means the cells were dead there. But what about the living cell? The living cell was first discovered by Antoni van Leeuwenhoek. Now, if a question comes, who discovered cell? The first answer has to be Robert Hooke. But he discovered in a dead tissue. Antoni van Leeuwenhoek, he discovered cell in a living cell. So, he collected some little leaves and some water from a little pond, and he tested them in a microscope, and he observed cells. So, cells were like little animals. So, then Antoni van Leeuwenhoek discovered a living cell. So, when Antoni van Leeuwenhoek observed cells in the microscope, they were living. But Robert Hooke discovered cells in a dead tissue, dead cork tissue, which is a tissue of oak tree. Oak tree means, in scientific name of oak tree is Quercus super. Now, this is about the discovery of the cell. Robert Brown, he's one more scientist. Robert Brown, he discovered the nucleus. So, nucleus is the acts like the brain of the cell. That means it has all the genetic material like the DNA, RNA, proteins. It has nucleolus, in that these genetic material are there. So nucleus is like it controls all the activities of the cell. So Robert Brown discovered the nucleus. This is the discovery of cell. Now there is a theory, or a cell theory, which is given, and that is called modern cell theory. Now, modern cell theory, the three scientists are, modern cell theory was given by Sclidon, Schwann. So, Sclidon, Schwann, and Rudolf Virchow. So, Matthias Sclidon, Theodor Schwann, and Rudolf Virchow. These were the three scientists who who formed this modern cell theory. So, these are the three points that they gave about cells. Basic things about cells, not like organelles or any other parts, just what is cell. So, this we can understand a cell by this modern cell theory. These were the three important points that they gave. The first one is, all living organisms are made up of cells. So, all living organisms are made up of cells. Now, no matter if the organism is small, big, or made up of one cell, or if it's a big organism, every organism, it can be, let's say, small organism like, let's say, insects, big organisms like elephants, amoeba, bacteria, humans, plants, animals, every living organism is made up of something which is called as cells. The next one is, cell is a structural and fundamental unit of life. Now, what does this sentence mean? So, if, for example, respiration, it's a living process. If it's a living process, let's take digestion. Digestion is also a living process. Digestion is the breakdown of complex food molecules into simple absorbable forms. Now, digestion is not formed, it's not like the, let's say, stomach. Stomach is an organ which helps in digestion. Stomach is not doing digestion there. The cells of the stomach are doing digestion. Like in the gastric glands, the goblet cells, and like adjunct fin cells, or mucus cells. These all cells are forming, they are forming a tissue, and all the tissues form an organ, and they are performing the function of digestion. So everything, let's say a dog is looking at you. That means there are some cells in the eye of, in your eye, that help in the brain. Like, let's say a dog is looking at you. If a dog is looking at you, your brain, that means there are some cells in your brain to your eye that help in the, that help in the message, like sending of the message. So you and the dog both has, that means the dog also has some cells which help in seeing. That means your brain and eye, your brain and eye both have cells which help in the message, transmission of message. So cell is the structural and fundamental unit of life. This is fundamental. That means fundamental means related to function. What does structural mean? Structural also means the same thing. Like, it means that every organism is made up of cells. The first point only. So so cell is a structural and fundamental unit of life. So functional. The next point is, all cells arise from pre-existing cells. Now, this is a very important one. These two, like all living organisms are made up of cells, cell is a structural and fundamental unit of life. These both were given by Sclidon and Schwann. But this one, all cells arise from pre-existing cells. So at the beginning, the cell theory was this one. Only these two points. But Rudolf Virchow modified the cell theory and he gave a new point, important point. It says that all cells arise from pre-existing cells. Pre-existing cells, that means Sclidon and Schwann, they thought that the cells arise from nothing. They come like, it's just like a magic. But this scientist, Rudolf Virchow, he explained that all cells arise from pre-existing cells. That means by the help of cell division, that is mitotic divisions, meiotic divisions, etc. So by this cell division, the cells are formed. So all cells arise from pre-existing cells. Now, in their language, like Rudolf Virchow's, in their language, this phrase, all cells arise from pre-existing cells, is called omnis cellula e cellulae. So all cells arise from pre-existing cells. In their language, it is omnis cellula e cellulae. So this is the modern cell theory. It says the first point is all living organisms are made up of cells. The next point is cell is a structural and fundamental unit of life. Fundamental means functional. Structural means like the structure. How is it made? Like an organ. Organ is made up of many tissues, and tissues also constitute of cells. The next one is all cells are as from pre-existing cells. Omnicellular is cellular is in their language. So this is the modern cell theory, and this is a discovery of cell. Now some important things about cell. The smallest cell. Now if anyone asks you, what is the smallest cell? You have to tell bacteria. But you need to be very specific whether they are asking with cell wall or without cell wall. Now if it's with cell wall, you can say bacteria, but without cell wall, it is mycoplasma. Usually, we will tell that mycoplasma is the smallest cell. And mycoplasma is, this is the smallest cell. That means it, and it's important to note that mycoplasma doesn't have cell. It lacks cell wall. And a cell that lacks cell wall is called protoplast. We all know that. So, mycoplasma, its size is normally 0.1 micrometers to 0.3 micrometers. So 0.1 micrometers to 0.3 micrometers is the size of mycoplasma. The next one, largest cell is ostrich egg. So ostrich egg, the egg of the ostrich. Now it doesn't matter if it is ostrich egg or not. Every egg, like if you take the normal egg that you use in your home, that is also a single cell. So usually cells are microscopic. That means we can't see the cells with our eyes. But there are some cells like eggs. They are visible. We can see them through our naked eye. So ostrich egg is the largest cell. The next one is an ostrich egg. This ostrich egg is 15 centimeters high. So its height is 15 centimeters and or let's say length. So 15 centimeters. Centimeters is the length and 13 centimeter wide. So 15 centimeter is the length of it and the breadth or the width is 13 centimeters. And we'll write it here. The longest cell is neuron. And neuron is the nerve cell. The cells that help in the transmission of the signals, the messages from our, let's say, any organ. It can be sense organ or a normal organ to our brain. So neurons are those cells. And this is the longest cell, and its size is 1.5 meters. So imagine how big it is, how long it is. Largest cell is ostrich egg, but the longest in terms of length, it is this one, 1 to 1.5 meters. Yes. So smallest cell is mycoplasma, largest cell is ostrich egg, and longest cell is neuron. This mycoplasma, it is a protoplast. So we'll add that also here. Mycoplasma is protoplast. What is protoplast? Protoplast is any cell that doesn't have a cell wall. It lacks cell wall. And bacteria, they are. What about bacteria? We have told bacteria is also very small. Bacteria is, it has a cell wall. That means it's not a protoplast. Why it has a cell wall? Because bacteria are the ancient. Like they are very ancient. They live in very harsh and very harsh conditions, harsh habitats, like salt, like halophiles, they live in salty water, like in very salinity areas, and like thermacidophiles, they live in very acidic and hot areas. And there are many bacteria like those which live in very harsh and very harsh conditions, harsh habitats. That's why they need cell wall, because they need protection, right? That's why. So mycoplasma don't have a cell wall. But whereas bacteria, they have cell wall. Then bacteria are not protoplasts. So this is about the basic discovery of the cell and the modern cell theory and some important things about cell, that is smallest cell, largest cell, and longest cell.